he threatens to topple the government. Knesset members set to vote for president on Tuesday. Harris and Abbas participate in prayer for peace at the Vatican. And Lady Gaga tickets go on sale in Israel. Shalom, and welcome to the Jerusalem Post News. Here are your headlines for Monday, June 9th. Yesh Atid leader Yair Lapid threatened to quit the coalition yesterday if the government decides to annex West Bank settlements, a move that has been of heated debate since peace talks between Israel and the Palestinians collapsed at the end of April.
If there will be a nisayon to support even one yeshuv echad beofen chatzdadi, Yesh Atid not only tifrosh mehamemshala, he gam tapil et hamemshala.
Lapid was speaking at the Herzliya conference, where he also called on Israel to freeze building in some West Bank settlements. Beit Yehudi leader Naftali Bennett also spoke at the conference, rebuffing Lapid's sentiments by saying that in his sovereignty plan, he calls for a gradual annexation of Area C of the West Bank.
Medinat Israel tachil ribonut adragatit ba'ezorim ha'israelim shebiyuda ve'shomron, ma shenikra shitchei C, sham chayim 400,000 Israelim ורק כ-70,000 ערבים, תוך יצירת אוטונומיה משודרגת ביתרת השטח עם חופש תנועה מלא לערבים.
On Tuesday, Knesset members will convene to vote for who will become the next president of Israel, set to replace current president Shimon Peres. Jerusalem Post's Knesset reporter Lahav Harkov is with us to explain the process.
120 Knesset members will vote for the next president tomorrow, Tuesday, at 11 a.m. There are five candidates at the moment. Reuven Rivlin from Likud Beiteinu, Meir Shitrit from Hatznuah, former Knesset Speaker Dalia Itzik, former Supreme Court Justice Dalia Dorner, and Nobel Prize winner Professor Dan Shechtman. There will be a second round of voting 3 hours later if none of the candidates get half of the Knesset's votes. And none of them are expected to get half because there's five of them. The race is really wide open and everyone's expecting surprises. No one knows who will win. Rivlin is expected to make it to the second round of voting, but who his competition will be in that second round remains to be seen. At the moment, it seems to be a battle of the Dalias. Dalia Itzik and Dalia Dorner have the greatest chance. Dorner didn't seem to have a chance in the beginning, but since Binyamin Ben Eliezer dropped out of the race because of a police investigation into his possibly illegally receiving funds to pay for his apartment in Jaffa, Dorner seems to be the main beneficiary of his votes.
Pope Francis, President Shimon Peres, and Palestinian Authority President Mahmoud Abbas prayed together yesterday at the Vatican, participating in an unprecedented prayer for peace. During his speech at the ceremony, the Pope urged both sides to put an end to the conflict, refrain from violence, and find the courage to restart dialogue between the two sides. Although the Pope was determined to term the meeting as a spiritual rather than diplomatic gathering, it was clear he had hoped the ceremony would help restart peace talks between Israel and the Palestinians. Following the ceremony, both Peres and Abbas separately reiterated their commitment to finding a peaceful resolution to the conflict. And Lady Gaga, American pop sensation, is officially booked to perform for her second time here in Israel. The star performed in Israel in 2009 to a sold-out show. Tickets for the show, called Art Rave, the Art Pop Ball, which will be on September 13th at Park HaYarkon, will go on sale this coming Wednesday. Her current international tour features stops in 35 cities as she performs her hits from her latest album, like Applause, Do What You Want, and G.U.Y. That's all for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more headlines. For now, shalom from the Jerusalem Post studios.